bell rings at 11 o'clock. The umpires are walking out into the middle. It's my time. So I'm walking to the crease, telling myself to stay cool, to relax, to watch the ball. I've got to the crease. I'm looking around, seeing where the opposition have set their field, make a few scratches on the crease, adjust my gloves, dance around a bit, get my feet moving. The bowler's ready, starts his run-up. So you're trying to show presence and be aggressive in your body language. You're the first man out there and you're ready to take on their attack.
But life's very different now for Joe Sayers. The pace has slowed. It's quiet. Joe's suffering from post-viral chronic fatigue syndrome. He's gone from being a pro sportsman to a man who struggles to get out of bed. From playing cricket for his country to wondering if he'll ever play again.
About 3.5 weeks ago, I started doing about 20 minutes strolling a day. Just a bit of walking, getting out of the house.
It's December and Joe's showing me around the stables near Harrogate where he and his wife keep a horse. He believes his illness was triggered by a bug he picked up on tour in South Africa last winter. When he got home, he tried to carry on playing for Yorkshire.
I was finding it hard to walk from one end of the wicket to the other. Came off the field, took my inhaler, and an hour and a half later woke up. I'd fallen asleep in the changing room, so then I knew it was something that needed sorting out. So I left the ground immediately, went to the doctor, and started to make plans.
The illness couldn't have come at the worst time.
He's there and he bowls and he's pegged into his wicket. It's all over. He's bowled by Tremlett and England have won their first series in Australia for 24 years.
Joe had been pushing for a place in a full England squad, but whilst they were in Australia winning the Ashes, he was in England telling me about his mental battle.
As soon as I start to expect, say, to get tired at 3 o'clock, I think in a way it makes it more likely that I will get tired at 3 o'clock. So it's been a process of just checking my thinking all the time and saying, no, it's not necessarily going to happen. You know, I might feel really fresh at three, I might feel the best I have felt at 3 o'clock.
There's no cure for chronic fatigue syndrome, so treatment is focused on the symptoms. Joe believes his recovery is dependent on mental strength.
You're a professional sportsman, what's your biggest fear with all of this?
My biggest fear? Good question. My biggest fear was that I wouldn't get back. And when we didn't have a diagnosis, the biggest fear was that we wouldn't find out what it was. And I wouldn't be able to explain what was going on. But when you're faced with that for so long, you have to face up to it, and you find a way of understanding that fear, and now I'm less fearful of that.
Joe's staying positive. He has to, because if he doesn't, the illness wins.
It's a good place to come to, really, for a bit of escape, a bit of exercise, walking around the grounds. Looking after this lad that takes a bit of effort.
Is he part of you getting fit again, getting back to...
Yeah, I think so. I mean, before I get back in the gym, I'm just looking at ways of staying active. I think it's, you know, small changes here, small changes there.
Being a sportsman is the best and worst thing for Joe. It makes it hard for him to be inactive, but it also gives him the tools to fight his fatigue.
A big part of the recovery is having faith in yourself, in your recovery, in your ability to come back and pacing your physical recovery back so that you don't have any setbacks. Yeah, it's been a journey, all right.
Physio next step, let's go.
That's right.
It's now February and Joe's back to where he wants to be. Cricket bat in his hands.
The wisdom I've gained from the last 8 months and the mental strength I've had to
to summon up to get through the last few difficult months. So thankfully I'm through the worst of it, and yeah, looking forward to the summer and the sun coming out. Yeah.
That positive attitude, the mental strength of a sportsman, reminds me of when I first met Joe. His determination was obvious then, and it's brought him to where he is now.
I think it does make you appreciate things a lot more. It's a bit like, in a way, having to retire from the game and then all of a sudden having the chance to get it all back. I think any sportsman that retired would jump at the chance.
That's
really
right, it's getting the chance. You're still young enough, 27 years old, you're still young enough to do that. Mm. You've looked at it now from the outside in, whereas before you were just on the inside.
Yeah, that's true.
And that's why I can understand you come back a lot stronger individual.
Just another chapter in the book.
A book? Cool. We've got a book coming here.